Welcome to Gaming Thing, your channel for everything related to the gaming industry and the financial markets, guys. And here it is, finally the video of my real life, my real world. This is a real portfolio, so this is real money in this portfolio. So over $55,000 right now. So in this video, we're going to check the different positions. I will give you some explanations, what I thought about this, and also where actually the positions are right now. So that's very important. So stay tuned. If you are into gaming industry stocks, into stocks from the gaming industry in general, so then this video is for you. So no charts at all here. So we're staying to this amazing picture that you're seeing. So, and now let's start, guys. So market value of this portfolio is now $55,465, and you see that I have, in general, I'm down over $3,000, so 5.69% down. So hey, you can see that's transparency. I'm giving you my real this is my real portfolio for all my gaming stocks that I have. So all of those stocks, guys, I am invested. So that's very important to keep in mind. I'm invested in stocks. So disclaimer, not financial advisor, YouTuber, blah, blah, blah. Don't buy anything like this. Don't copy this. Because you see, it's very difficult. You can lose money. So why do I have stocks like Microsoft here? Yeah, Microsoft, I mean, they have the Xbox and they're going to acquire, hopefully, Activision Blizzard soon. So this will pop up to $96, hopefully, but we don't know yet. And of course, you can see Microsoft is my 27.85% position, over 93% up, over $7,000 up. And then my second biggest position is Activision Blizzard, is also 46% up, and this could go up much further with an acquisition by Microsoft. So I'm always telling you, if you buy specific gaming companies that are very small, micro stocks, penny stocks probably, don't invest a lot, guys. Don't invest a lot. Always diversify properly. So you see, I actually diversified massively in this portfolio. I have like from Microsoft to some super tiny, almost, let's say, almost or a company that's a lot in financial troubles, and they are working on the next payday. So Starbreeze working on the next payday 3. You see here, in comparison to the overall gaming portfolio. So also keep in mind, I have other stocks as well. So this is just one part of my overall portfolio. With the gaming companies, I have a company now just newly I bought Starbreeze, and I bought it then for like 1290 Swedish crowns. So that's 0.22% now of my portfolio. So that's around about $100-$120, so not really a lot. So but you can see already, so I just bought this very recently, and now the stock is already down 17.90%, so minus $26. So if I would have bought this now with a huge position, then I would already be down massively. But this is a very volatile stock, and that's the stock. It's also not like a clear bet like Microsoft, or like Microsoft's also not a clear bet after you have run up like that, like Microsoft $308 now. So it's not a clear bet anymore. Also, here, as you see, I have actually Take-Two. So I have now more Take-Two stocks than I wanted to have, since Take-Two was also single. So I got some more Take-Two stocks. But you see also here, I'm 21%, almost 22% down. Then we have CD Projekt, a Polish gaming company that makes Witcher and Cyberpunk. Here you can see this is now 8.85%, but also minus $4,000 down. Now you say, oh, Mr. Orange, why are you buying those stocks when you're always down? Guys, investing is extremely risky. And I think with this gaming portfolio here, I'm showing you how risky it is. So one stock, for example, CI Games, I was selling with over 100%, obviously. No, not any earlier. So all of those stocks out there where I'm still invested in. So guys, and then you see a Corsair. I bought Corsair probably at the wrong time. I traded it a little bit before, and then I bought it at the wrong time, and now it's also already minus 31% down. Razer minus 28%. Unity minus 62% down. So, but you see the positions also. If this would now, for example, if Unity software wouldn't be minus 62% down, if it would be now zero, then I would have like invested like 5,500. $100, and then it would be about 10% of the portfolio. This would probably be much, but I hope also that in general, in relation to all the stocks go. Guys, you see, I have like Microsoft and Activision, Take-Two, CT, Libre, Corsair, Embracer, Ubisoft. So I talk a lot about Ubisoft, but Ubisoft stock is 44% down. And you see, it's a 3.57% partner of the portfolio. So I see, for example, here room to invest. Tencent, I'm a big holding company with gaming companies under them. So Playway, a gaming company from Poland as well. Here I'm 35% up. But you see also here I didn't invest so much because still it's a Polish gaming company. So I cannot expect this to run up 35%. I know this. Rovio, I also didn't know that that they're going to be getting acquired by Sega. So how would I know this? Then otherwise for 55% up, I would have invested more. That's the point, guys. We never really knew in which direction go. So Big Ben, now I bought a lot more. Now we're at 606 euros, but we're still then almost down. So this also stopped down a little bit. Then newly acquired some shares of holding. So here you see I bought so for 500 euros. So that's what I bought, for example, in Frankfurt in Germany. So here you see also already minus 1.8% down. So maybe I'm also average. Bit Square Enix is an old company. It's a popular company. They exist since a long time. So that's a company. Invested in also a company that's not visible here, like Square Enix. It's Bandai Namco. I'm also invested there. Cannot put app. So it's also around euro. So Digital Bros, minus 20%. They had a terrible day on Friday. They made Crime Boss the game. I'm also going to make video about this, what happened to Digital Bros recently. Then Star Wars Industry, the Invincible, the demo you can download now on Steam. So plus 40-50%, guys. So Focus Home also plus 5%. Team 17, also a gaming company that I newly bought, now minus 3.58%. And here I can honestly tell you, it was so difficult to buy this stock in London at the stock exchange. So there was like zero volume in my broker, zero volume really. So it was very difficult to acquire this. So it cost me like double the fees. Since one time it was just filling one position and then I was buying more. Now I have 70 shares of 17. Then Naken, I got them after they have been split out of Big Ben. Now I also bought Naken. You see, now I'm up in Naked, so very interesting. Uber also, tiny position, Ultimate Games, out of Playway, tiny position. Then Starbreeze and Digital Bros are linked. Starbreeze and Embracer are linked. So you see also a lot of those gaming companies that you can invest in, and mostly those European ones, are all linked with each other. So always keep this in mind. So if you're interested, if you want to know more how those gaming companies link to each other, then also comment and like this video, of course, tonight. More future. So guys, you see, at the moment and the market circumstances where like stocks like Meta and Microsoft going up like crazy, so probably it's an interesting approach to invest in gaming companies, but that this is only part of my portfolio. So I have a little bit more than $55,000, of course, invested, so I wouldn't go all in gaming stocks. So I use gaming stocks because I know the field, I know the gaming companies, I know games, I know how people that play the games, if they spend money. I'm part of the consumer, so I better understand the gaming industry. Therefore I like investing in gaming companies, and therefore you see I invest a lot of micro stocks, a lot of stocks that other people would call penny stocks, maybe could call them risky, but I also don't put all my eggs in one basket. I also too much in smaller companies, but of course I also have to put the Microsoft here because it's probably one of the biggest gaming company, but Microsoft makes other products. So if you enjoyed this video, if you want to see the development of this portfolio, because I'm going to cover now this portfolio regularly on my channel, so therefore please subscribe to my channel and also write down if you have more information to specific stocks. And now, disclaimer, I'm investing in all of those companies and in Bandai. And this is not financial advice. I'm a YouTuber, a retail investor myself. So make up your own mind. Don't invest in anything you see here. Don't copy invest. Please, please don't do this. So make your own research, guys. This is for you to learn and to also to see mistakes that I do and also to learn from others. So, you know, it's risky. You see, I'm down. Do you want to be down 5.69% here? Probably not. So therefore, don't copy. So thank you very much for watching, guys. See you next time. Bye-bye.